Good morning, everyone. How are you all? So here we are meeting with another session, and this is the first class of NCERT, that is history. So we'll discuss some kind of questions and what is the edge of NCERT in this examination. So we'll discuss about that and how it is important, and what is the weightage of such questions which UPSC asks in prelims and in the main. So we'll discuss these things. Okay, so we start the session. So can I know something about aapne agar abhi if you have started your preparation, you both. So have you read NCERT, or you are reading it, or have you, you know, if you are seeing any problem while reading it, so what is your experience with NCERT? Nahi padhi hai. And you?
I started reading now.
You started, okay.
It's taking more time, and actually on repetition, two or three more readings, and I'll get overall grip on all of the 11th and 12th. With one class to another class links there, you know. So it's taking time for me to cover. So I thought that it's taking time.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, actually, you know what happens, and just understand what is the importance of NCERT in the examination. And you know, it is very important to understand that, you know, new books of NCERT, that is themes series. I was going through some questions of CDS. Some of my students asked me some questions that was regarding to peasants revolts. Okay. And when I was going through that question, what was the source of that question, and I saw, as it is, they had copied those lines from the themes series. So UPSC's examination, like another examinations apart from these prelims, CSE, that is civil services, so apart of these examinations, whatever examination UPSC is conducting, or any other examination which is conducted by states, so they have study materials, or they have the source from those theme series from the history section. Okay, so theme series is important for that. Many of my students, and that was my problem when I was preparing for the UPSC, that was my problem also, what source we need to follow for the NCERT, whether we should go for old NCERTs, whether we should refer new NCERTs. So if you are preparing for CSE, that is civil services, so for that you have to refer only old NCERTs. Okay. And whenever you prepare, just take some time for your preparation. Okay. It is not necessary that while going through your coaching classes or while going through your self studies, you will get your examination successfully, you know, done in a year, or you know, because many of our fellows or many of the students, they come and, you know, they prepare, like they have joined some coaching classes, and they have, you know, there is an idea in their mind that they are going to clear next year. But okay, it is okay, that is your, you know, you a kind of booster for yourself, but in your mind you should take some time for your preparation, because it is not that easy, but it is not that difficult too. Okay. And for every subject, if you have, you know, clear concepts on NCERTs, okay, because if you see geography, in geography book, each and every line is having concepts, each and every line. You cannot skip a line, a single line, okay, whether you can, you can relate to any chapter in NCERT. That is, for example, I have told you about geography, and this is similar for history. Do you know history has some concepts, and once you get it, you will never forget it. Okay, so it is very important to understand that. And students, they Tamil board NCERTs, you know, Tamil board NCERT, I would refer, if you are referring to NCERTs or Tamil board, just refer to one. But I would always suggest go for NCERT, because if you go for Tamil Nadu, so Tamil Nadu, they have some selective readings, or they have some additional facts over chapters, and this is not as useful or as you know, for your answer writing practice. So I would never suggest go for Tamil Nadu, because you cannot have that those kind of you know, words or kind of phrases which are mentioned in the NCERT, and that is helpful for your answer writing also. Okay. Kuch puchna tha. Okay, I thought your expression was like that. Okay, so NCERT is very important for any subject preparation for this examination, and I would suggest for your studies, for your readings, go for 6 to 10 classes. Okay, this is your actually homework. If you are preparing or you have joined any coaching classes, or here you are, you have joined for NCERT only. So we will go through all such classes, because every class have some parts, and in the 11th, 12th NCERTs they have additional over it. Okay. Whatever is there in 6th to 10th classes, so different themes are there, like it starts from ancient, then it goes to medieval, then modern, then world history. Okay, and in the 11th and 12th, they have some a level beyond on those subjects, okay, on those sections. So we'll discuss it, and some additional facts are also there. So I was on I was discussing about the theme series. So in the serious examination, that took place in February this year only, 2019, and there were some two questions. One was from 1857 and another one was from Peasant Revolt. And you know, each and every line, the question framing of those questions, they just copied those question, those line, and they have just put it into the question. Okay, and the option, the correct option, they also copied it. So for and as you have time, you have your number of attempts, so you must be, you know, go for another examination also. So this is important to understand. You can read such books also, but the problem is time is the very big constraints whenever you prepare. So for that, I would suggest just clear the concepts in every subject in your mind, so that you will you can never forget whether it regards to any subject, okay, whether it is history or polity or any other. So just stick to one, because as I said, that time is a big constraint. So I would have some discussions over Mahesh. For your understanding, I would suggest go for 6 to 10 first. Why? Because lots of things are there, and you need to understand what is the basics behind any chapter or behind any subject. So I would suggest like 6 to 10 is mandatory for your understanding. Okay, it is helpful for your understanding, because many a times it happens like you cannot connect with the things. And you know, NCERT is the source which we read since our childhood. And our CBSE is having NCERT as their curriculum. But in the in our schools, like when I was in 11th, so I opted commerce, but hardly I read NCERT books. But for economics, here we have to read NCERT. So this is the importance of NCERT, which UPSC has understood, but not our curriculum, not our schools. Okay, so this is the only problem. Like we face difficulty while reading NCERT, while understanding NCERT. Okay, so NCERT 6 to 10 is mandatory for everyone. Why? To clear up, at least to have a base. Okay, concepts kahan pe hoga? In the 12th standard or 11th standard. Okay, there you can build your concepts. And you know, how you can connect it. Go through chapters, whatever chapters you have read from 6th standard, like ancient history is there in the 6th standard. Okay, then 7th mein medieval hai, then modern, then world history. So what you have to do, whatever facts you have read in the 6th standard, and you move on to 11th standard, like ancient history is there in the 11th standard, just correlate it, try to correlate it, because some additional facts are over there. In the 6th standard book, you cannot find concepts, okay, you cannot find concepts in each and every lines, but you have to analyze it. Like in the theme series, there are some ranges they have mentioned, like Kirtha range. Okay, so they have mentioned what all settlements over there, and that belongs to what settlement. Okay, and what were the evidences we found over Kirtha range. So that is given in the 6th standard theme series. But you have to analyze it. You have to analyze it. Okay, agar wahan pe wheat cultivation tha, so what all settlements could be living there? कहाँ से हमें मिलता है वीट का कल्टीवेशन के एविडेंसेस? कालीबंगा में तो वीट का नहीं है एक्चुअली. यू कैन सी इट फ्रॉम महेंद्रगढ़, that Balochistan area, Neolithic settlement, Mahendragarh is the place, the Balochistan wale region mein, Neolithic settlement. Okay, so that you need to analyze it. Okay, it belongs to Neolithic settlement or it belongs to a certain place, so okay, theek hai, wahan pe ye cultivation hota tha. So you can correlate these things. Additional facts, you can get it in your upper classes, like 11th or 12th. Okay, so you have to just correlate these things. So for that, just whenever you start NCERT, just start from 6th. Okay, 6th to 10th, then for concepts, you have to read 11th, 12th. Yes, I'll discuss over it, Dipankar, what all we are going to cover here in this session. Okay, so we would discuss over it. Okay. So, first we should understand what is the syllabus of history. Okay, because this is important to understand what is the syllabus of history for prelims and for the mains. And are you aware of your syllabuses? Are you aware? How much are you aware? Huh? Little bit. Okay. You know, whenever you start any preparation, chahe wo class ka ho, chahe wo college ka ho, chahe wo UPSC ho or any other examination, first task for yourself is to understand syllabus. Like, make it as a Bible. Why? Because you have to cover everything according to this. Whether it is related to current affairs, whether it is related to any subject, GS subject. Hai na? Because what you have to do in the current affairs, I'm just giving you a reference. Theek hai, usko discuss nahin karenge, bas ek reference de rahi hu. What we have to do in the current affairs, we have to cover only those sections which are mentioned in your syllabus as part of your GS. Hai na? It makes so bulky whenever we read newspaper. Lots of news are there and every day there are some news. But how we have to retain and what we have to read and what we have not to read. Hai na? Iska answer kahan se milega? From syllabus. Okay, so once you understand your syllabus, once you understand what all subjects you have to read and what all areas in that subject you have to read. And that answer you can get from your syllabus. So understand it. Go and take a printout whatever UPSC has syllabus. Okay, you can get it from the website, download it, read it. Okay, read every paper, all the four GS papers, essay, read about essay, what they are asking, what kind of questions they are asking in the essay, what is the syllabus of ethics, it is also abstract, what is the syllabus of GS1, okay, what is the syllabus of GS2, so understand it. If you have opted your optional, go through, what is the syllabus of your optional, so understand it, okay. Yes, Akshay, for this UPSC civil services examination, it is mandatory to refer old NCERTs. Why? Because it would help you for your concept building plus answer writing. You can analyze any question which UPSC is asking in prelims and in the mains. The source of that question belongs to NCERT, not from any other subject. Not from any other source. Okay, NCERT is the basis of that question and you can get the answer in the NCERT itself. Whatever books we refer na, like Bipin Chandra or any, for the history I'm just telling you, or any like my mentor who mentored me, so he used to refer like Discovery of India for History. Then many books were there and I have those books, D.N. Jha, then I opted history optional, okay, then Upinder Singh, lots of things, these are for ancient history, okay, but you know, where I found my comfortability was NCERT. Why? Because anything which is mentioned on those reference books, they have the source from NCERT itself. But what they have done, they have just upgraded it with another evidences or facts. That is it. This is for example, I'm just saying for the history thing. Okay. So NCERT is the Bible for this examination. So just understand each and every word in the book. ठीक है, एंड बिफोर दैट ईच एंड एवरी लाइन इन द सिलेबस. ओके, जैसे लाइक इन जी एस वन, व्हाट आर द पेपर्स इन द जी एस वन? हिस्ट्री है, हिस्ट्री में क्या क्या है? हाँ, मेडिवल, मेडिवल नहीं है, सो वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू हैव टू रीड इन हिस्ट्री, व्हाट यू हैव टू रीड इन हिस्ट्री फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एंड फॉर मेंस. सो फॉर प्रीलिम्स यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर एंशिएंट medieval, modern and art and culture. ठीक है, these four areas you have to prepare for your prelims examination. But there are some differences in the mains examination. Some difference in the actually you cannot say it a difference, but they have some, you know, variation kind of thing in the mains examination. What is that? You have to prepare art and culture, modern, postmodern, some additional things are there. ठीक है, then world history. So these are the sections you have to cover in the mains examination, and these are the sections you have to cover in the prelims examination. From ancient and medieval, what you have to do here, you have to cover political history. ठीक है, so here you have to cover political history from ancient and medieval, and cultural part is there, that is another section which is mentioned exclusively. ठीक है, सो आर्ट एंड कल्चर लाइक कल्चरल पार्ट और ट्रेडिशनल पार्ट ऑफ दैट हिस्ट्री, एंशिएंट एंड मेडिवल. ठीक है, एंड मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री एंड इंडियन नेशनल फ्रीडम मूवमेंट. ओके, सो दैट इज पार्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री, गांधीयन एरा, लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स आर देयर इन द मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री. ठीक है, इन द आर्ट एंड कल्चर व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इन द मेंस एग्जामिनेशन, ठीक है, इन द आर्ट एंड कल्चर सेक्शन यू कवर्ड योर कल्चरल पार्ट ऑफ एंशिएंट एंड मेडिवल. Now you have to cover that part in art and culture. So that is belongs to ancient and medieval. Although they have mentioned that cultural part from ancient, medieval and modern. But there are very few chances when they are asking about modern history from cultural part. Why? Because modern history is there in the syllabus. That is the part of the main syllabus. Okay? So why they would ask about cultural part in the mains examination? So they ask you cultural part from ancient and history in the mains examination, and for from modern they have another section which is exclusively mentioned in the mains examination. So here they would ask you question from national movement, Gandhian era, or another leader and Gandhian's views. Like this year they asked about this year they asked about Ambedkar and Gandhi, something like that. इस साल था अंबेडकर या इसके पहले था, बट हियर दिस ईयर ऑल्सो आई थिंक नॉट अंबेडकर बट अनदर कंटेम्प्रेरी लीडर्स के साथ दे आस्ट. ठीक है, डिफरेंसेस इन द आइडियोलॉजीज, सो सम काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन लाइक दैट. देन 1920 एडिशन, दैट इज आई डोंट हैव एनी आइडिया वॉट इज इन द 1920 एडिशन. इफ दैट इज पार्ट ऑफ ओल्ड वन, लाइक ओल्ड एनसीईआरटी, सो इफ दैट इज ओके, बट आई डोंट थिंक सो दे हैव 1920 एडिशन ऑफ ओल्ड एनसीईआरटीज, बिकॉज दीज डेज वॉट एनसीईआरटी इज फॉलोइंग इट्स करिकुलम, दैट इज थीम सीरीज. ओके, थीम सीरीज इज देयर इन द स्कूल करिकुलम, सो आई डोंट थिंक सो 1920 बिलोंग्स टू ओल्ड वन. I would tell you what all writers are there in the older NCRTs. Okay, so I would tell you about that. So we were on the syllabus. So from modern section, they ask you question from national freedom movement or Gandhian principles or differences like these 2 years consecutively I've seen like they are asking about the ideological differences with Gandhi and another leaders. So they ask they are asking question like that. Then another section is postmodern. So what is the meaning of postmodern?
After independence.
But what all areas they would ask you? Any idea? Lots of things happened after independence. ठीक है, food security में changes we saw. Then you said economic reforms were there. Then emergency period was there. Okay, many big events we can see. So you have to prepare it accordingly. ठीक है, and I would tell you the weightage of questions from these sections also. Then another part is world history. So world history is about like contemporary to India. ठीक है, लाइक वट ऑल बिग रेवोल्यूशंस वर देयर लाइक इन द वर्ल्ड लाइक अमेरिकन रेवोल्यूशन, रशियन रेवोल्यूशन, फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन, इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन. सो दीज आर देयर. एंड यू नो वाई दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ द सिलेबस, वाई वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री इज पार्ट ऑफ द सिलेबस. दिस इज इंडियन सिविल सर्विसेज, सो वाई वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री? हाँ, कोरिलेटेड. कैसे? हाँ, लेकिन देखो हाउ अमेरिकन रेवोल्यूशन इज कोरिलेटेड, हाउ इंडस्ट्रियल इज कोरिलेटेड. सोचो इसके बारे में थोड़ा सा, मतलब फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. इकोनॉमिक सोर्स कैसे? ऐसे समझो, ठीक है, मेनी थिंग्स हैपेंड. इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन इट डायरेक्टली इंपैक्टेड इंडिया, है ना. आफ्टर दैट इंडिया बिकेम अ कॉलोनी ऑफ ब्रिटेन. बट व्हाट अबाउट अमेरिकन रेवोल्यूशन? वी इंस्पायर्ड समथिंग फ्रॉम अमेरिकन रेवोल्यूशन, वी इंस्पायर्ड समथिंग फ्रॉम रशियन रेवोल्यूशन, है ना. रशियन रेवोल्यूशन से तो पूरा पूरा इंस्पिरेशन था, दैट इज मार्क्सिस्ट कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी, है ना. अमेरिकन रेवोल्यूशन व्हेन आवर फ्रीडम मूवमेंट वॉज गोइंग ऑन, सो मेनी ऑफ आवर लीडर्स they inspired from American Revolution, no taxation without representation, our moderates, hai na. So uska major events jo hai world ke, that is why it is part of our syllabus. Okay, so what's your name?
Naeem.
What's yours? Yahan pe nahi hai, yahan ka environment theek hai. Okay, it's okay, it's okay, don't be sorry. Okay, so have you prepared or have you given any attempt of UPSC? You all are freshers. Next year 2020 you are targeting. So what is the status of your preparation? Going with flow. Okay, thoda sa loud tha. Because you know I'm down with cold, to thoda sa sunne mein problem hai, it happens with me. Okay, so theek hai. So we were on the importance of NCRTs. What is the importance of NCRT for your preparation? Okay, so have you found difficulty or what kind of difficulties you faced while reading NCRT? Okay, so I was on the syllabus, so I just divided these sections like prelims and mains and the edge of history syllabus in the prelims and mains. So these are the partition I have, you know, I have not analyzed, but that is given in the syllabus. So are you aware of your syllabus? If not, then you should and go and download the syllabus and understand what all sections you have to read. Okay, so these are the part of the prelims like ancient, medieval, modern and culture. And here there is some difference in the mains, that is culture, modern, postmodern and world history. Okay, so these are the sections of prelims and mains. Ab isme se questions kitne aate hain? How many questions you get in your prelims and in the mains examination? So in the prelims number of questions in history, so it varies. It varies like 15 to 20. Sometimes less than 15 to. Lekin 10 se niche kabhi bhi questions nahi aaye in the history section. Like minimum number of questions I saw in history, that was 11 questions, and maybe some 2-3 years back, okay, 16 or 17. So 15 to 20 questions ka you can target in the prelims examination, and that is from all the areas. Okay, so majorly the sections from where UPSC is asking question is modern India. Okay, because lots of themes are there in the modern India. क्या क्या हो सकते हैं, जैसे गांधी का हुआ या अनटचेबिलिटी मूवमेंट हुआ, सोशल रिलीजियस रिफॉर्म्स है, नेशनल मूवमेंट है, 1857 है. वैसे रेयरली दे आस्क क्वेश्चन ऑन 1857, बट दे हैव सम यू नो कोरिलेशन काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. देन पेजेंट रिवोल्ट्स आर देयर, ट्राइबल्स आर देयर, लॉट्स ऑफ इवेंट्स हैज हैपन्ड ड्यूरिंग मॉडर्न पीरियड, सो दे कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दैट. देन नेक्स्ट section from modern, like number as part of number of questions, so that is art and culture. Okay, so like 5 to 7 question you can see in the paper, so it varies, number varies. And from ancient and medieval, like from medieval period they can ask you some question based on terms, like so and so term belongs to, and in the context of medieval India this term belongs to what kind of questions. Okay, then in the you can see in the art and culture or in the ancient, they would ask you at least one question is there from Buddhism and Jainism, hai na? Every year they ask question, like in 2019 they asked question, there were some three statements, okay, three statements like deification of Buddha and two more are there, I don't remember that the question, and that belongs to what sect of Buddhism, those statements belongs to which sect of the Buddhism, so how many sects were there in the Buddhism and when it came, so you have to prepare these things. And how you can see the changes, and you have to understand what were the differences in the ideologies, differences in the ideology of those sects, hai na, why it started, why Jainism, Buddhism, and that was during ancient period, so these things you have to understand. Okay. Gazetteer of India, Dipankar, don't burden yourself. I would suggest to everyone, do not burden yourself. Lots of subjects are there you have to prepare for this examination. History, polity, geography, and every subject is having like variations, like different subsections are there from every subject. Hai na? So why to burden yourself? When you understand the basis of NCERT, so you are done like 90% of your syllabus. Okay, the work, like 90% understanding of your subject, that you can take help from NCERT, not from any other subject, not from any other reference, not subject. Okay, so I would not suggest to go for gazetteer or gazetteer, actually it is. So do not go for that, because you will only burden yourself. Okay, and this is for everyone, do not burden yourself. Lots of references are there, so how many references you would go for, hai na? So where were we, number of questions. So theek hai. So number of question varies, so and you have to prepare it accordingly. Okay, now in the mains examination, in the mains examination two types of question they would ask you, one is 10 marks question, another is 15 marks question, and number of words also varies. Like 10 marks questions you have to write 150 words, and in 15 marks question you have to write 200 words. And from these two types of questions they would ask you questions from history also. Okay, like from ancient, from art and culture, they would ask you one question from 10 marks and one question from 15 marks. Okay, and that is for another sections also, like from modern history. This year they didn't ask question on postmodern India. There was no question from postmodern history, but it doesn't mean that they would not ask you any question from postmodern history. Okay, so every year they ask like 7 to 8 questions. This number also varies, but 7 is max minimum and 8 is maximum. So 7 to 8 question, it varies. They ask question from this history part. Okay, so two questions you can see, two from modern, two from art and culture, one from world history, probably one from postmodern history. So like these, that these numbers varies. Okay, so these were some. Now I would take some references how you have to start history or NCERT. Okay, so first your homework is to go for like 6 to 10. Okay, next session whenever we would meet, so I am expecting like you would done at least 6th standard. Okay, so complete 6th standard NCERT for history. Till then, whenever we would meet, if we are meeting next week, then 1 week is enough for 6th standard, you know. So read that, and I would take some background of history, okay, from 11th standard. Okay, so first question is, what is history? What is history? Why we are reading history? That is important for the UPSC preparation. But what is history? Study of past.
Stories of past.
So what is prehistory? Which one book can completely help me to cover history portion? Santosh, there is no one book for anything. Okay? You guys are very much confused in terms of books. I would come on history. Okay, pehle books ka discussion kar lete hain. First thing is, go for NCERT as we are in the NCERT session. NCERTs. ठीक है, गो फॉर एनसीईआरटी फॉर ईच सब्जेक्ट. फॉर हिस्ट्री व्हाट यू हैव टू डू आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग दीज एनसीईआरटीज, रेफरेंस बुक्स. बिफोर मूविंग ऑन टू बुक्स, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट क्वेश्चंस दे आर आस्किंग. ठीक है, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दे आर आस्किंग. यू कैन take an idea from 10 years question, past 10 years questions. So see and analyze the areas from where they are asking the questions and accordingly prepare yourself. Okay, why? Because so many chapters are there in particular subject. If your history is there, so four sub subjects are there in the history, four sub sections are there in the history, and every section are having 15 to 20 chapters, 15 to 20 themes. In modern history, there are lots of themes. Every year they have come up in, with the themes in the history, modern history section. Hai na, kya kya themes ho sakte hain? In the, if you see social religious movement, lots of movements are there in the Hindu religion, in Islam religion, in Christianity, in Sikhism. Lots of movements are there. How you would retain. Lots of events in the modern history. Augustofer hai, like after war, 1940. Augustofer, when World War II was going on. Individual Satyagraha, Rajaji formula, Liaquat Desai Pak. Lots of things are there. So how you would retain. So what you have to do, understand and analyze what questions they are asking. What is the theme of the questions? In the mains, not in the prelims. Because for prelims, you have to read NCERT, and NCERT is having answer of all your questions. You do not have to burden yourself among reference books. Okay, so NCERT has covered everything what UPSC asking is asking questions on. Okay. Charanjit, I told you have to complete 6 to 10 standards book, and here in this session we would cover 11 and 12 standard books. Why? Because 6 and 10 is a pre-level of 11th and 12th. So whatever understanding you have to develop on the subject, so we would discuss here in this session. Okay, in the sessions, upcoming sessions. So for yourself, this is 6 to 10 for your self-study, and for the session 11th and 12th, we would take. So reference books, I was telling, for ancient theme, for ancient India, what you have to do, go for R.S. Sharma. R.S. Sharma is the writer of NCERT, Ancient India, and he has written one more book, that is India's Ancient Past. Okay, that is extension of this NCERT book, nothing else. So that you can refer for prelims and for cultural part also. Okay, Then for medieval, same writer you have to follow, like Satish Chandra is there. And Satish Chandra's book is History of Medieval India. Okay? Then for modern, Bipin Chandra's NCRT. Mahesh, time you have to manage, okay? Like, you have to retain whatever facts or whatever concepts are there in the history, then take your time. I am not going to suggest you. Why? Because that depends on your understanding. How much time you take to understand the things or the themes, okay? So, but I would suggest like 4 to 5 times of readings are required for any reference or any NCRT. Why? Because 4 to 5, at least 4 to 5 times mein you can retain yourself. Hai na? Repetitively readings mein you can retain whatever things you are going on. So at least 4 to 5 times, but if you are not able to get, then go for another readings also. And here it is also important when you have to prepare notes. So when you should prepare notes. That not mandatory. Have you prepared notes? No one. While going your first going for your first reading, just go for a lateral reading. Okay, only simple reading you have to go through. In the second reading, you would start understanding. Okay, agar second reading mein bhi nahi samajh mein aata, then go for another reading. Okay, and after understanding the things, understanding the topics, then just note it down. Okay, only crisp notes are important to make. Why? Because pura note banane ka, there is no sense. You do not have to write another book. You have to make notes for yourself, like crisp notes. Whenever you need it, you can read it like that. Okay, so after like whenever you understand, okay, it depends on you. If you are able to understand in the second reading, then make notes after that. If third reading, then make notes after that. So it depends on your understanding. Okay, so modern India, there is Bipin Chandra, that is NCRT, and Bipin Chandra's another book is History of Modern India. Okay, red color's book, red color ka book hai na, so that you have to refer for this. Okay, one more book is there, but you know, I don't think so if you can get in this market. There is another book which is helpful for you in the answer writing, in the GS, as well as if anyone is about to take history option. So that is very helpful for answer writing only. That is Raj to Swaraj. Suna hai kabhi? Have you heard of it? Raj to Swaraj. Writer is R.C. Pradhan. And you know, this book is very much useful for your answer writing, because every chapter he has covered. So he has covered in a way that is going to help you. Like they have mentioned about cultural nationalism. What is the meaning? What should be the meaning of cultural nationalism? What is the concept of that? And this year UPSC asked question on that. अगर आप लोगों ने देखा हो मेंस का क्वेश्चन तो सेक्युलर नहीं नहीं एक्चुअली दे आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन ऑन द 20th सेंचुरीज सोशल रिलीजियस मूवमेंट इम्पैक्ट्स ऑन नेशनलिज्म नेशनल मूवमेंट देयर दे आस्क्ड सम क्वेश्चन ऑन कोरिलेशन ऑफ दैट सोशल रिलीजियस मूवमेंट विद द नेशनल मूवमेंट ओके सो क्या हो सकता है व्हाट इज नेशनलिज्म What is national? Actually, it is not. ठीक है ये तो what's a quantitative? No, qualitative. Qualitative thought है. ठीक है quantitative thought क्या हो सकता है? So we would discuss in the further sessions what is nation, what is nationalism, what is cultural nationalism. I'm just giving a reference. Like lots of themes are there in that book, and this is that is not anything which is alien to you, which is unknown. Nothing is there. Whatever whatever NCRT has covered, whatever topics NCRT has covered, so those topics are there in this book. And this book is recommended only for the answer writing. Okay, language is very easy and the coverage of chapter is like that because they have covered the event, what happened, how it happened. So that comes under the event. Analysis over the event. What is the analysis over the event? Kya ho sakta analysis?
What happened
means an event has happened. Okay, analysis kya ho sakta? Uska limitation ho sakta hai, uska contribution ho sakta hai, significance ho sakta hai, consequences ho sakte hai. So these are different analysis over the events. This term cultural nationalism, actually that has come as a reference of an analysis over the event, and that event was social religious movement. Okay, cultural nationalism. If I talk about nationalism in the country, so nationalism in the country, it doesn't came in the form of patriotism. Patriotism mein to nahi aaya tha na nationalism. If you have any idea, if you have read about 1857 event, if you have gone through, so was there the concept of nationalism? Was there the concept of nationalism in the country? Tha ma'am?
Freedom.
Freedom. Freedom bhi nahi tha. Kaise tha? नेशनलिज्म कैसे नहीं था वो सोचो कैसे नहीं था. थैंक यू. कैसे नहीं था, कैसे समझे कि नहीं था. लाइक वट एवर सेक्शंस वर देयर, whosoever section was fighting for their independence, not for India's independence. है ना, concept of India was not there, concept of territory was there. है ना, so what a nation belongs to, what a nation is having. A nation is having a territory, a nation is having a population, a nation is having a sovereignty. And India is a nation. We all are citizens of this nation. We have that feeling of nationalism, patriotism. So in India, nationalism concept, it doesn't came with patriotism, it came with cultural nationalism. How cultural nationalism? Because the concept of nationalism started in the India, that started in the form of religious nationalism. How? Social religious movement. Hai na, during social religious movement, what happened? What used to happen before that? People were deprived of their rights. People were unaware of their rights actually. Whatever was happening with them, they thought that this is the part of their culture. They never thought that this is the part of suppression of their thoughts, of their rights, of their livelihood. Hai na? So that feeling that came after this social religious movement, and that was the contribution of different leaders. Different leaders, they fought for different problems. Okay, like Rajaram Mohan Roy. He fought for right to life. Right to life tha na, sati system. Hai na? So usko na cheezon ko try to correlate. And this correlation, it doesn't mean to history only. You can correlate it with another subjects also. ठीक है? नहीं, question type नहीं है. They have covered every chapter. Every chapter they have covered, और हर chapter में they have covered in a way like they are covering the event, then they are covering the analysis over it. Okay? So you can get it online. अभी नहीं इसको रेफर करना है. एनी रेफरेंस बुक यू डू नॉट हैव टू रेफर राइट नाउ, यू हैव टू गो थ्रू एनसीईआरटी फर्स्ट. व्हेन यू कंप्लीट योर एनसीईआरटी, व्हेन यू मेक योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ओवर एनसीईआरटी, देन गो फॉर एनी अदर रेफरेंस बुक्स. ठीक है? एंड हाउ यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फॉर आंसर्स, फॉर आंसर राइटिंग, दिस इज ऑल्सो अ चैलेंजिंग टास्क. है ना, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, पहले तो पूरा सिलेबस कवर कर लो, उसके बाद एटलीस्ट स्टार्ट वन सब्जेक्ट, स्टार्ट विथ वन सब्जेक्ट. Finish one subject first, make your notes. Start, whenever you start writing, start with notes making. ठीक है, वही दो तीन बार कम से कम पढ़ो, then try to note down the things. बल्कि notes नहीं बनाना है, line by line नहीं बनाना है. Mention the event and mention what were important things happened during those events. ठीक है, उसके बाद क्या करना है, उसी theme से related, take out some questions from previous years. Related to that event, related to that topic, then try to write your answer. What you have understood till now, ट्राई टू राइट एनीथिंग, जो भी आता है दिमाग में, कुछ भी, ठीक है. उसके बाद व्हेनेवर यू राइट, व्हेनेवर यू स्टार्ट राइटिंग, देन यू वुड एनालाइज व्हाट शुड बी यू नो अपग्रेडेशन, अपग्रेडेशन, अपग्रेडेशन इन योर राइटिंग. ओके, सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट. सो फर्स्ट स्टार्ट with reading, then go for note making, then try to write answers, and that is from previous year questions. Okay, so we were on what is history,
stories of past.
Stories of past. Have you heard a term called prehistory? Wo kya hota hai fir? Okay, prehistory, history, proto history. But what is the meaning? Why UPSC has taken the term history? Why not prehistory or proto-history?
We know our past means we can present and future we can proceed.
So what is prehistory then? If history is the past, what is prehistory? Before past?
We don't have the facts or the things of prehistory. That's what we call prehistory. And the facts about the civilization, the things about the civilization, the past story about the civilization, that's what we call history.
Actually, see, you are somewhere, you know, near to that definition. What is the meaning of history? Yes, this is about our stories or our past. But in what form? In the written form. Whatever we have available in the written form about our past, that is history. Okay? What is prehistory then? We know our past, but we have nothing in the written form. Evidences are there, but nothing is there in a form of text. ठीक है, कुछ भी टेक्स्ट में तो नहीं है ना अबाउट द प्री हिस्ट्री. हाउ डू वी नो अबाउट आर प्री हिस्ट्री? थ्रू सम ड्रॉइंग्स, थ्रू सम पिक्चर्स, है ना. पिक्चर से वी जस्ट एनालाइज, ओके, इफ दे हैव ड्रॉन समथिंग, इट बिलोंग्स टू, इट लुक्स लाइक अ मैन, इट लुक्स लाइक एन एनिमल, सो इट मस्ट बिलोंग टू देयर डे टू डे टास्क और डे टू डे लाइफ, है ना. कुछ एनालिसिस ही रहा होगा हिस्टोरियंस का, आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट का. कुछ रिटन फॉर्म में तो नहीं है ना अबाउट प्री हिस्ट्री. देन व्हाट इज प्रोटो हिस्ट्री? प्रोटो हिस्ट्री सुना है? विच पार्ट ऑफ आर हिस्ट्री बिलोंग्स टू प्रोटो हिस्ट्री? एप्स? नहीं, नो दीपिका, रिटन डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. वी डोंट हैव द रिटन. About what? History or prehistory? No, Mukesh, Rashtra Swaraj is helpful for GS also, not for optional. Optional is very different from GS answer writing, because in the optional they have certain themes. They have tendency to ask from like each and every section, they try to ask question. But in the GS section, and this Rashtra Swaraj book, so that is helpful in the GS mainly. Okay, optional ka answer writing is little bit different. So this Rajan Swaraj, Mukesh, this is for your GS, not for optional. And yes, Deepika, we do not have script in the prehistory. Okay, theek hai, chalo. Where were we? Haan, proto-history. Which part of our history belongs to proto? And what is this? Yes, that is true. We don't have any written documentation over it. That is prehistory. We know about our prehistory through some diagrams, through some pictures, whatever we have found as an evidence. Proto-history is Indus Valley Civilization. Why it is proto-history? That is history. We have some evidences. This is proto because we do not have written evidence, but we have something in the written, but we do not know about it because it hasn't deciphered yet. We have a script, but it hasn't deciphered yet. Okay, अभी तक उसका हम उसको decode नहीं कर पाए हैं. Although we have a script, but we haven't decoded it. ठीक है? So that is proto history. Proto means we have evidences, we have written record, but we are not able to understand it. Okay, so Indus Valley belongs to our proto history. After Indus Valley civilization, we enter into history thing. Why history? आफ्टर इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन ऋग्वेदिक एरा कम्स, आर्यन केम इन इंडिया, है ना, आर्यन इन्वेजन. सो ऑल्दो देयर टेक्स्ट दैट बिलोंग्स टू दैट पीरियड ओनली, बट वी फाउंड इट लेटर ऑन, बट वी हैव सम एविडेंसेस. ऋग्वेदास, दीज आर इन द रिटन फॉर्म, है ना, एंड द फर्स्ट एविडेंस वी फाउंड इंडिया इज हैविंग दैट बिलोंग्स टू, नहीं, एविडेंस अबाउट रिटन रिकॉर्ड. रिटन रिकॉर्ड कहां से मिलता है? फर्स्ट एविडेंस नहीं, दैट वी हैव डिसाइफर्ड. वी हैव नॉट डिसाइफर्ड येट. रिटन रिकॉर्ड वी हैव, बट वी हैवंट डिसाइफर्ड इट. डिसाइफर्ड रिटन रिकॉर्ड, सोचो, बहुत बार पढ़ा होगा. नहीं, अशोका, अशोकाज इंस्क्रिप्शन, हैव यू हर्ड ऑफ इट? अशोकाज इंस्क्रिप्शन के बाद ही तो हमारे हिस्ट्री का सारा खोज पड़ताल हुआ. देन वी गॉट टू नो अबाउट आवर हिस्ट्री. आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट, दे डिसाइफर्ड, they decided, then they came on a conclusion that belongs to Kharoshthi, that belongs to Brahmi. Then they deciphered. So first evidence, first written record, that belongs to Ashoka, theek hai, Mauryas, Ashoka, Mauryas under Ashoka. So first evidence we are having in the written record, written form, that is Ashoka's inscription. Deepika, yes, for understanding it is okay that is a transition, but this is not a transition period. Just go through the historical chapters we have to read, like pre, proto, then history. So just understand it. For prehistory, we do not have any evidence. We have evidences, but not in the written form. But the proto history section, this is not a transitionary period. How you can relate it to the transition period? As prehistory, that is, you know, no civilization, no society was there. But in the proto history, we had an urban civilization, an urbanization, and that was we compare it from today. And that was highly civilized civilization during that time. So this is not a transitionary period. Proto means is we have written records, but we are not able to decode it. ठीक है, so उसका simple meaning यही है proto का, nothing else. So this is not a transition. ठीक है, वेवा वीव इससे पहले, हाँ, so Ashoka's inscription is the first written record we have, and after that another records. Archaeologists, they started reading and decoding, and they started translating those records in English or in any familiar languages. Okay, they got some Sanskrit texts, then they converted or translated into that into English. Okay, so aise hi history ka padhte padhte through some, you know, texts, they got to know our past, and just understand it. When we will go through the chapters, so you can analyze those things, like what was the glory of India during ancient period, then how it shattered during medieval period, then why another outsider came like Britishers, and what was the situation of the Indian society during that time, why so many years they held here, why so many years they spent in India, but they never culminated into the society. इससे पहले, बिकॉज यू कैन सी एज इफ आई से इंडिया इज लैंड ऑफ इन्वेडर्स, सो इज इट ट्रू और रॉन्ग? समवेयर इट इज ट्रू, समवेयर इट इज ट्रू. आफ्टर इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन वी कैन नॉट सी एनी, यू कैन सी इंडिजीनियस सेटलमेंट इन इंडिया. इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन के बारे में, ऑल्दो वी डू नॉट हैव एनी रिकॉर्ड, if Indus Valley people, they belong to Indian land or they also came from outside, we do not have any evidence. So we can have an analysis that they must be belongs to that, belongs to this land. Theek hai, they must be belonging to India. Then after, if you can see Aryans, so Aryans ke liye what term historians use? Aryans invasion, hai na, Aryan ka invasion hua tha, they came from outside central Persia. They started moving from central Persia. Why they started moving from central Persia? Because they were nomadics, and they were always seeking for a better condition of life. Nomadics ka kya hota hai? Nomadics are like khana badosh, tribes hi hote hain nomadics, and they always look for certain good life, certain another good facilities for their life, for their livelihood. So they were like that. And why it is called invasion? What is the meaning of invasion? Whenever we use the term invasion, it means like confronting. है ना, जब भी इन्वेजन का वर्ड, इन्वेजन वर्ड हम यूज करते हैं इन द हिस्ट्री और एनी वेयर, सो इट मीन्स लाइक कन्फ्रंटेशन बिटवीन टू सेट्स ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. ओके, सो दैट इज वाई हियर इट इज सेइंग आर्यंस इन्वेजन. इफ आई इफ यू कैन सी लाइक इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन पीपल यूज टू लिव हियर. एंड हैव यू गाइज एवर गॉन थ्रू भारत एक खोज, कभी सुना है या पढ़ा है उसके बारे में? भारत एक खोज कभी नहीं सुना? किसी ने नहीं सुना? सीरीज है, सीरीज एक्चुअली ये टेली सीरीज हुआ करता था. ओके, व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू मुकेश, आई डू नॉट हैव एनी इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट इट. आई ओनली हैव इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट माय सब्जेक्ट एंड दैट इज फॉर टुडे ओनली. ओके, सो व्हाट एवर क्वेरी यू आर हैविंग विद अदर सब्जेक्ट्स, यू कैन आस्क फ्रॉम द कंसर्न पर्सन. Okay, from the office person, because I don't have any information about it. So here, I think we should concentrate on the session presently. Okay. So Bharat Ek Khoj, actually Bharat Ek Khoj is nothing. Discovery of India book suna hai. Discovery of India is a book written by Jawaharlal Nehru. Okay. And in that book, he has written from since ancient civilization, that is Indus Valley civilization, and that was like contemporary when he was in the jail, and he used to come out of jail. So that was during that time. So complete national freedom movement ke se pehle hi wo book khatam ho gayi thi. So what he has done, he has written the evidences, or he has written as a story form, like whatever events has been happened, and that book has converted into a teddy series, and that was very old teddy series. Okay, and that teddy series is available on the YouTube, Bharat Ek Khoj karke. So what I'm trying to say, in the Bharat Ek Khoj, they have shown like Indus Valley civilization, that was a trader society. They the mass of the population belongs to a trading society. Okay, and when these nomadic people, these Aryan invasion took place, so how in the form of invasion it took place, they started moving towards India from central Persia. They started moving towards India, and the settlements who were living in those areas, like Sapta Sindhu region. We will know the term, what is Sapta Sindhu region, we'll read about it. I'll just giving an overview. Okay, so in the Sapta Sindhu region, they were Indus Valley civilization settlements. So a full-fledged civilized society is there, and a nomadic tribe is moving towards that society. And the civilized society, they were very peace-loving people. Okay, why peace-loving people? Because through evidences we got to know that they we have not found any weaponry. No weaponry evidences are we have found from Indus Valley civilization. So there is a conclusion, they must be peace-loving people. And they there was absence of kingship. Because if kingship is there, so there must be an army. There must be a standing army. If there must be a standing army, then there must be some weapons. So that is the conclusion, that because we have found some seals which we found in India, that belongs to another overseas, another Mesopotamian seals we have found in the India, and Indian seals we have found in the Mesopotamia. So they correlated these things, that okay, there must be some trading relations. Okay, and when this Aryan invasion took place in India, there had some confrontation. We would read about Das Rajan Yudh. Okay, Das Rajan Yudh, that was nothing. Das Rajan matlab 10 kings, and 10 kings that belongs to Aryans and non-Aryans tribes. Okay, and they confronted with each other 5-5 karke. Okay, and whosoever emerged victorious, that held the position, and that was Aryans. Okay, so Aryan invasion, by historians came on a conclusion, that is called an invasion, because when peace loving people used to live there, and they came from outside, and they were far superior than the settlements living in India. How superior they were? Because they belonged to that terrain that was very difficult, okay, difficult to live. They had fine quality of horses. Okay, they had fine qualities of implements. Implements means tools, okay, weapons. So on that basis, they not better than us, but dominated. Okay, they dominated the living settlement in India. Okay, like this concept is there in the your ecology section also, environment and ecology, hai na? Invasive species ka concept hai. Kya hota hai invasive species mein? Exactly. If they are dominant, then they hold the area, that relationship, commensalism, amensalism, hai na? Wahi cheez India mein bhi hua tha, wo hamesha se hota raha tha. And this is the, you know, part of nature. Whether it belongs to ecology or ecosystem or belongs to our lives. So that is the part of nature. Wo nature ka nature hai actually. ठीक है, सो दैट हैपेंड देन. सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सच थीम्स, व्हाई इन्वेजन, व्हाट वाज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन, व्हाई वी आर कंपेयरिंग दैट सिविलाइजेशन विद इंडिया, देन व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन आर्यन स्टार्टेड लिविंग. ओके, दे व्हेन दे केम, दे हैड देयर सेटलमेंट ड्यूरिंग सप्त सिंधु रीजन. सप्त माने सेवन, सिंधु माने बिलोंग्स टू, नियर बाय टू सिंधु. सिंधु वॉज इंडस, है ना, इंडस को ही बोलते हैं ना. सो व्हेन दे केम थ्रू सप्त सिंधु रीजन, सो सेवन रिवर्स वर देयर, अश्किनी, परुशिनी, चेनाब. सो ये सब कुछ रिवर्स थे. विल डिस्कस अबाउट दोज थिंग्स व्हेनेवर वी गो थ्रू दी चैप्टर्स. ठीक है, एंड दीज आइडियाज यू कैन हैव इन दी 6 to 10 एनसीईआरटीज. ओके, वेदर इट बिलोंग्स टू एंशियंट और मेडिवल, सो वट एवर थीम्स वी विल डिस्कस हियर, यू कैन हैव दोज आइडिया इन योर लोअर क्लास एनसीईआरटीज. ठीक है, तो उसको नेक्स्ट टाइम से पढ़ के आना है. सो वी कैन हैव सम ओवरव्यू आर सिलेबस, बट वी हैव टू गो थ्रू. ठीक है, सो आज का एक इंडक्शन सेशन ही रखते हैं. नेक्स्ट सेशन से वी विल डिस्कस दी चैप्टर्स. ओके, सो वी हैव टू स्टार्ट विद दी प्री हिस्ट्री. वट वी हैव टू रीड इन दी प्री हिस्ट्री, फर्स्ट बिफोर मूविंग ऑन टू दी प्री हिस्ट्री, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वट आर दी सोर्सेज वी आर हैविंग टू अंडरस्टैंड हिस्ट्री. क्या हो सकते हैं सोर्सेज, थ्रू व्हाट वी गॉट टू नो आवर हिस्ट्री. हाँ, हो सकते हैं. और सील्स के लिए ना, देखो सील क्या है, वो एक पर्टिकुलर सिविलाइजेशन को बिलोंग करता है. ठीक है, सो दिस यू कैन से एज एन एविडेंस. ठीक है, फाइंडिंग. व्हाट आर दी सोर्सेज ऑफ सोर्सेज टू नो हिस्ट्री. हिस्ट्री को जानने के लिए ना तीन सोर्सेज होते हैं. क्या हो सकता है, फर्स्ट एपिग्राफी. क्या होता है एपिग्राफी, कभी सुना है, पढ़ा है हिस्ट्री में, स्टडी ऑफ इंस्क्रिप्शंस. What is inscription? What is the meaning of inscription? नहीं, inscription is, उसको हिंदी में ना अभिलेख बोलते हैं. ठीक है, इसमें देखो एक बहुत ही फेमिलियर सा एक वर्ड होगा, स्क्रिप्ट. इंस्क्रिप्शन में स्क्रिप्ट है ना, सो इट बिलोंग्स टू स्क्रिप्ट. But that script that has written on stones, okay. So earliest inscriptions that used to record on stones, जैसे अशोका, अशोका का कहाँ मिला था inscription? Inscription ही तो बोलते हैं ना उसको. Where we found Ashoka's inscription that was recorded on stones, ठीक है. So first sources to know our history, that is epigraphy, and in the epigraphy we can know about our written texts, ठीक है, written records. So written records and that is in the ancient form. That is epigraphy. Another is what you were saying, that was numismatic. Study of numismatic. Study of what? Coins. Numismatic. NUMIS. MATIC. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट इज लिटरेचर्स, थर्ड वन, एंड दीज लिटरेचर्स आर वॉट वी आर हैविंग इन द प्रेजेंट फॉर्म. ओके, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बुक, इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ मेन्यूस्क्रिप्ट. ठीक है, मेन्यूस्क्रिप्ट क्या होता है? छोटे से नहीं होते. अरे मनु और स्क्रिप्ट, मनु कौन था? ठीक है, सो मनु के नाम पे मनुस्क्रिप्ट हो गया. व्हाई? बिकॉज दे यूज टू राइट ऑन ताम्रपत्र होता है ना, दे यूज टू राइट ऑन दैट और बार्क ऑफ लीव्स. ओके, सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड मेन्यूस्क्रिप्ट. मेन्यूस्क्रिप्ट इज अ रॉ फॉर्म ऑफ स्क्रिप्ट. ठीक है, सो लिटरेचर, सो थ्रू दीज थ्री सोर्सेज वी कैन नो अबाउट आर हिस्ट्री. ठीक है, सो यहीं पे आर प्री हिस्ट्री दैट वॉज लैगिंग इन दीज थ्री. ओके, ना वो एपिग्राफी को बिलोंग करता था, नीदर न्यूमिज्मैटिक नॉर लिटरेचर. सो दैट इज माई प्री हिस्ट्री. वाई? बिकॉज वी हैव एविडेंसेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पिक्चर्स. ठीक है, देन प्रोटो हिस्ट्री. सो प्रोटो हिस्ट्री का भी यही प्रॉब्लम था, वी हैव नथिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ राइटिंग्स एंड वट एवर स्क्रिप्ट वी आर हैविंग थ्रू दैट बिलोंग्स टू प्रोटो हिस्ट्री, दैट इज इन दिस वैली सिविलाइजेशन, दैट इज इन पिक्टोरियल फॉर्म. पिक्चर्स बने हुए हैं सील्स के ऊपर, एंड कहाँ मिला? सील के ऊपर. सील्स से ही वो स्क्रिप्ट को सोचा कि ओके दीज मे बी दी स्क्रिप्ट एक पिक्चर फॉर्म में होगा. एंड देर इज अ टर्म दे हैव यूज एंड अबाउट द स्क्रिप्ट. व्हाट इज दैट? मैं खुद ही भूल गई, छोड़ो, नेक्स्ट क्लास में आई विल टेल यू. हाँ सॉरी, क्या? नहीं, मैनुस्क्रिप्ट नहीं था. अरे आई फॉरगॉट दैट टर्म, वेरी बिग टर्म इज दैट. ठीक है, थोड़ा थोड़ा दिमाग में आ रहा है, चलो विल डिस्कस इट लेटर ऑन. बॉस्टोफ्रोजन, दिस इज अबाउट इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन स्क्रिप्ट. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट? स्क्रिप्ट रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लाइक फर्स्ट लाइन जो है वो लेफ्ट टू राइट है, देन अनदर लाइन इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम राइट एंड इट गोज टू लेफ्ट. मतलब फर्स्ट लाइन लेफ्ट टू राइट, देन अनदर लाइन, लाइक अभी हम क्या करते हैं, लेफ्ट टू राइट, लेफ्ट टू राइट, लेफ्ट टू राइट. सो दे हैव कंटिन्यूड फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट, देन लेफ्ट टू राइट, देन राइट टू लेफ्ट. दैट इज, हाँ वैसे ही, दैट इज बॉस्टोफ्रोडन. ठीक है, एंड दिस स्क्रिप्ट दैट वॉज इन द पिक्टोरियल फॉर्म. So that is why we have not able to decipher it. Okay, pictures में क्या decipher कर सकते हो आप? उसको ऐसे ही आप decipher कर सकते हो कि whatever pictures on the seal imprinted, we found Mesopotamian seals. That pictures imprinted on Mesopotamian seals we found in India, and same seal if we are finding in Mesopotamia, Harappan seal. So there must be some correlation. What kind of trade they used to have, and what was the use of that picture in that in the trade, and that what signifies. ठीक है, so through that they may be, and in future we can expect if it get deciphered, but there are many few chances of it. क्योंकि अभी तक तो नहीं हो पाया, and many archaeologists, very renowned archaeologists we had, so we cannot say if going forward we can have a deciphered script from ancient Indus Valley or not, so we cannot say. ठीक है, so ये कुछ होते हैं. Then through our about our history we have some records, we got to know about some records through foreign accounts. What is the meaning of foreign accounts? Like foreign historians, they used to come to India, like जैसे फॉरेन अकाउंट्स, नॉट ओनली हिस्टोरियंस और फॉरेन ट्रैवलर्स, लाइक वी हैव ह्यूएन त्सांग, आई जिंग, और क्या था, हाँ फायान, देन इन द मेडिवल पीरियड यू कैन से नसीर, नाम ही भूल जाती हूँ, बता रही हूँ. जैसे विजयनगर में डोमिंगो पाएस और न्यूनिड्स, सो लॉट्स ऑफ फॉरनर्स, whether it is Italian or Portuguese, or you can see in the ancient texts like Pliny ka book hai, then Strabo's book. So these are some, you know, some foreign accounts, some foreign historians or foreign travelers who used to visit to India and they used to write something. Okay, they used to actually, what was the writing? They used to compare, because in the ancient period we had a very glorified society. Whether it is civilization, Indus Valley civilization, we know about it. Why it is called a civilization? Acha, chalo, theek hai, ispe bhi discuss kar hi lete hai. What is the meaning of civilization? Are we civilized? Do we belong to a civilized society? Why we belong to a civilized society? एक सेकेंड, यस दीवम, यू कैन सी दिस वीडियो लेटर ऑन इफ यू आर हैविंग एक्सेस ओवर इट एंड यू मस्ट बी हैविंग एक्सेस सो यू कैन सी द वीडियो लेटर ऑन. हाँ, कहाँ थे आप? सिविलाइजेशन. वाई इंडस वैली इज कॉल्ड इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन? हाउ दे वर सोफिस्टिकेटेड, हाउ दे गॉट टू नो, हाउ हिस्टोरियंस गॉट टू नो दैट दे वर सोफिस्टिकेटेड? हाँ, और थ्रू देयर, देखो सिविलाइजेशन क्या होता है, लाइक वी आर हैविंग अ वेरी वेल प्लान्ड लाइफ. व्हाई? वी आर अ सिविलाइज्ड सोसाइटी, वी आर एजुकेटेड, वी नो व्हाट इज राइट, व्हाट इज रॉन्ग, वी नो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, व्हाट वी हैव नॉट टू डू. ओके, we know basic etiquettes. Like if you see Indus Valley civilization, can you think of it like the civilization that is very previous, very old, but the way they used to live, that is like very advanced kind of. Proper well drained system, proper well cutted roads were there, proper well maintained houses were there, and those houses that was built from burnt bricks. है ना, जैसे आज भी ईंटों से ही घर बनते हैं, जो बर्न्ट ब्रिक्स होती है उससे. एंड दैट हाउसेस वी फाउंड ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड, एंड दैट वाज वेरी एंशिएंट सोसाइटी, एंशिएंट पीरियड सोसाइटी, है ना. तो सिविलाइजेशन मीनिंग, इफ एनी सेटलमेंट इज कॉल्ड सिविलाइजेशन, इट मीन्स दैट इट इज हैविंग दोज कॉम्पोनेंट्स विच बिलोंग्स टू अ मॉडर्न सोसाइटी. इफ is Rig Vedic a civilization or a rural society? Civilized tha, this Rig Vedic period. How they were civilized? Achha, ek aur cheez hai. In the civilized society, you can see the livelihood of the people that is more advanced. They are having money. ठीक है, they must be belong, they must belongs to like trading section. Why trading section? Because in the trading section, people have money. People have a good lifestyle. If you can see in today's scenario, if farmers, they are living a well, good life, they are having a good livelihood, or a business person is having a good livelihood. Situation of, what is the situation of farmers in India? In the present scenario. Achha hai, bura hai, kya hai? Huh? Some people are having, you know, bad livelihood, some people are having like moderate, some are good, belongs to farmers. But if you see the modern business society or working society, so they are much far better than farmers. Theek hai, if you see Rig Vedic, you said Rig Vedic was a civilization, I just tell you the difference. Just see the Rig Vedic society was a nomadic society. They were nomadic tribes. ठीक है, ट्राइब्स थे, दे यूज टू मूव फ्रॉम हियर टू देयर, दे वर, दैट वाज अ पैस्टरल सोसाइटी. व्हाई पैस्टरल? बिकॉज अर्लियर दे यूज टू लिव ऑन एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, है ना, पशुपालन, दे यूज टू लिव ऑन एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, ऑन कैटल्स. कैटल्स वर कॉल्ड, कैटल्स वर द वेल्थ ऑफ दोज ट्राइबल पीपल. ठीक है, later on during later Vedic period, what happened there we can see the change in the nature of society. That animal husbandry or pastoral society that turned into agricultural society, they changed their occupation from animal husbandry to agricultural occupation. Theek hai, So this doesn't belong to civilization. Why civilization? Why not civilization? Because they do not have proper houses. They are not living in a proper society. है ना, अभी भी they were tribes. They do not had any kingdom. There is a term in history, urbanization and second urbanization. In the ancient history, urbanization, and that is in the ancient history, urbanization and second urbanization. कौन कौन से period हो सकते हैं in the ancient history? Urbanization is Indus Valley. अच्छा, ये ऐसा भी नहीं था कि इंडस वैली में ऑल द सेटलमेंट्स दे वर अर्बनाइज्ड, दे वर रूरल सेटलमेंट्स ऑल्सो, बट मेजोरिटी ऑफ द, और यू कैन से से दैट द टैक्स पेयर्स, काइंड ऑफ टैक्स पेयर्स, सो दे वर इन द मेजोरिटी, एंड दो सेटलमेंट्स हु यूज टू लिव नियर बाय रिवर्स इंडस वैली, ओके, हु यूज टू लिव इन द इंडस वैली रीजन और नियर टू एनी रिवर, लाइक लोथल, लोथल इन द गुजरात. Lothal is, we found evidence of dockyard, okay? And from that dockyard, they used to send their goods to another places, like overseas, like Mesopotamia, okay? So, near settlements nearby rivers, they were more civilized, they were more urbanized, because the people who used to live over there, they had burnt bricks houses, okay, modern houses, and they had roads, road, what say, 90 degrees cutting roads, okay, they had drainage system. People who used to live nearby rivers, they were, majority of the population, they involved in the trades, okay, and that is why they had a better condition of life as compared to another settlements like Kalibanga. Kalibanga was a rural settlement, okay, why it was rural settlement? Because we found an evidence of wooden furrow. Wooden furrow is what? That is used for ploughing. है ना, खेती करने के लिए जो यूज करते हैं, that is, उसको क्या हल बोलते हैं, है ना? So plough. So we found an evidence. Okay. So rural society या urban society. So that differentiate with the occupation people living in the society belongs to. ठीक है, सो अर्बन सोसाइटी इन द इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन दैट बिलोंग्स टू द पर्सन हु वर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द ट्रेड, एंड रूरल सोसाइटी बिलोंग्स टू द पर्सन हु वर इन द एग्रीकल्चर, एंड दैट इज इन द केस ऑफ अनदर सेटलमेंट्स ऑल्सो, वेदर इट इज ऋग्वेदिक और लेटर वैदिक. सो वैदिक पीरियड सोसाइटी, दैट वॉज नॉट अ अर्बनाइज्ड सोसाइटी, ओके, दैट वॉज नॉट अ सिविलाइज्ड सोसाइटी, दे वर नोमैडिक ट्राइब्स. I was on the second urbanization. Later Vedic period mein, when people started moving towards eastern India, okay, Sapta Sindhu region, that was in the western part. I'll discuss through the map in the further sessions, okay? So Sapta Sindhu region, that was in the western part of India. Then during later Vedic period, they started moving towards eastern part of India. Okay, why eastern part of India? Because those nomadic tribes, and you know, those tribes in the Indus Valley Rig Vedic society, so there was not a particular tribe, lots of tribes were there, okay, but emerged tribe was Bharat, that is, on that name we got this name Bharat Varsh, okay, so Bharat was the tribe or a clan who emerged victorious, okay. Then another tribes, they also used to come, and if there was a clash or clash for supremacy, then that is why there is a term, there is an event in the history that is called Das Rajna Yudh, okay? So that is a war of 10 kings. Why? Because they used to, they wanted to dominate over India, and there were clashes between some clans or some tribes, okay? So majority of tribes, when different tribes belongs to Aryan clan, they started moving towards India, then with the growing population, what they will do? They will move to another places. So they started moving towards Eastern India. And Eastern India, during that period, we used to have very, you know, huge rainfall. Rainfall ki wajah se, and in the Eastern India, you can see towards Ganga Valley, okay, Ganga Plains. That is very fertile area, okay. Fertility is there, and that is very forested part of the region. That used to forested part, but nowadays because of growing settlements, lots of trees are cutted. But that is, you know, those region today itself, they get a huge amount of rainfall, and that was during that period also. So they started moving towards Eastern India, and they started settling down. Okay, when they started settling down, they at any place, people, if people are living, they just analyze what is good in that region and what is bad in that region. And that was their, you know, good luck. Then the region, the part of the Eastern India where they started settling, that had natural resources. Okay, natural resources like iron. Okay, iron. And in the eastern part, you can see surroundings, that is south to Ganga Valley. Okay, Ganga Valley, jaise Ganga ja rahi hai, Ganga bisects Bihar and Jharkhand. Okay, so during that, at the surrounding of that southern part of the Ganga Valley, that part is rich in iron. Okay, like Jharkhand wala, wo chota Nagpur wala jo area hai, so, and various other minerals are also there. And with the help of those iron, they started upgrading themselves. Okay, and when they started upgrading themselves, then the concept of territory, that started turning into concept of kingdom. During that period, we find a term called Janpads. Okay, Janpad mane a particular territory. Mahajanpad mane confederacy of those territory. Okay, and those territory that converted from tribal society to a territory or a kingdom. Okay, and that is the second urbanization, when these Aryan, they started settling down in those regions, the eastern part of the India, and with the help of those natural resources, they started demarcating their territory. And from there only we get the concept of kingdom and kingship. Ek marked territory hai, and us marked territory ko, there needs some leader to lead it. There needs some leader of the tribe to protect the society, to protect the population of that tribe. So from there, that emerged the concept of kingdom, okay, and the kingship. And we can see during later Vedic period, there are lots of yag, they used to happen. Hai na, priestly class jo tha, they used to suggest, achha, aapko ye problem hai, you just go for Ashwamedha. You want to expand your territory, go for Ashwamedha yag. What they used to do in that, they used to had some yagya. Then during that yagya, they used to have a pair of horses, and they just freed that horse to go anywhere, and till the territory that horse used to stop, that territory belongs to the particular king who has led the horse in that direction. So that was the significance during that time. So the nature of the confrontation, and if any clash used to happen after this Ashwamedha, then they used to have a war. Okay, war between the king and the territory. Okay, any territory belongs to the another king, then they had some wars. Okay, if another king whose territory that he has lost because of this Ashwamedha yag, if he is not that superior to the king who has performed this Ashwamedha yag, then he used to surrender himself. Okay, agar surrender nahi kiya, then there were war. Okay, so there we can see. And why this second urbanization? Because that is the period when we see the use of natural resources, and because of these natural resources, we can see the pattern of kingship and kingdom. Okay, So that is why it is called second urbanization. And in this second urbanization, we got the concept of Mahajanpads, like 16 Mahajanpads. 16 big kingdoms were there. Some were small, some were big. But and why these 16? Because they had some powers. They were powerful as compared to another tribes. Okay, so tribal society, now they converted into a kingdom society. Okay, so that is why this period is called, and this period is that belongs to 6th century BC. Okay, jab Magad wala region we formed, we can see the Magad region and we can see different kings. And Magad, why Magad became the most powerful among another 15 Janpads? Because that region, they had good natural resources, iron tha, okay? And because of that, and that region, that that was surrounded through hills, okay? You can see the Magad region in the map also. Wo jo region hai, that is you know, somewhere south to Ganga. And you can, if you have read in your geography, like mineral resources, so you can see the importance, today's importance of that region. तो एंशियंट में तो पता नहीं कितना होगा, तब तो कोई एक्सप्लॉयटेशन भी नहीं हुआ था. ओके, सो दीज आर देयर. देन सो टू नो हिस्ट्री वी वर ऑन लाइक द सोर्सेज. ठीक है, देन वी वुड मूव ऑन टू प्री हिस्ट्री, प्रोटो हिस्ट्री, देन दोज इवेंट्स. ठीक है, वट वर देयर, वट वॉज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द पिक्चर्स इन द प्री हिस्ट्री. एंड इन द प्री हिस्ट्री यू कैन रिलेट इट विद योर कल्चरल पार्ट ऑफ द हिस्ट्री, बिकॉज देर वॉज नो, देर वर नो पोलिटिकल पार्ट ऑफ हिस्ट्री ड्यूरिंग प्री हिस्टोरिक पीरियड. ठीक है, प्री हिस्ट्री में क्या था, सिर्फ कल्चरल ही तो पार्ट है. वी हैव ओनली पेंटिंग्स, वी डू नॉट हैव सोसाइटी. ओके, वाई दे यूज टू मेक पिक्चर्स, वाई वी आर हैविंग पिक्चर्स ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड. If society was not developed, there were no concept of society, then what is the significance of pictures? Why they used to paint? Why they used to draw those pictures? Human nature. Time pass. Yahi hota hoga, aur kya hota hoga? Society to thi nahi, they were hunters and gatherers. है ना, वट दे हैव टू डू. सुबह उठा, अब सोचो आज खाना क्या है नाश्ते में, आज तो हम भैया यही खाएंगे, ये दिखे आज तो यही उठा लेंगे हम. ठीक है, फिर दिन का लंच, फिर रात का डिनर, है ना. तो उसमें वो क्या करेंगे, दे यूज टू लिव इन द केव्स, नो प्रॉपर हाउसेज, देवर हंटर्स एंड गैदरर्स. हंट किया, गैदर किया, हंट किया, गैदर किया. ठीक है, सो वट एवर दे यूज टू डू इन अ डे, दे यूज टू पेंट इट. एंड वेन दे यूज टू पेंट इट ड्यूरिंग रेनी सीजन, वेन दे यूज टू लिव इन द केव्स, तभी होता होगा. Because see the time period of the prehistory. Okay, prehistory was the period that belongs to the period when there were you know, huge rainfall used to happen. Okay, what is the term, Heliocene ya kuch aise hai na, jab bahut zyada se ice hua karta tha. Heliocene ya kuch bolte hai usko, I don't remember the term. Matlab geography thoda sa in mamle mein weak hai, baaki mamlon mein nahi hai. Okay, so Pleistocene period. Okay, so these were the period when India used to have, not only India, world used to have, you know, a huge amount of rainfall. So what was the you know, part of amusement, that was they used to draw pictures as a part of their amusement. Okay, and you can see lots of themes of those pictures. There are single pictures, like a single man they have drawn. And significance, our historians has found some significance. They were not so significant towards future, that future will know about us. But historians or archaeologists, they have identified the significance. Kya kya signify kiya? Like concept of geometry. How geometry? Snake line nahi tha. जो पिक्चर्स वी हैव फाउंड फ्रॉम प्री हिस्टोरिक पीरियड, दैट इज कॉल्ड लीनियर रिप्रेजेंटेशन. लीनियर, लीनियर होता ना, ज्योमेट्री का ही पार्ट है ना, लाइंस ड्रॉ करना, ट्राइंगल्स जो कि लाइन फॉर्म में बनती है, लीनियर रिप्रेजेंटेशन. कैसे था लीनियर रिप्रेजेंटेशन, लाइक दे यूज टू ड्रॉ अ सर्कल, देन फॉर द बॉडी दे यूज टू ड्रॉ अ लाइन, and for the torso they used to draw some triangle kind of, hai na, aise hota tha. Then they had some like hands, hai na. So that our archaeologist has analyzed over it. What is the significance of these pictures? The concept of geometry, linear representation. Then what about this circle? What about this triangle? So kya hua? Okay, theek hai, koi nahi. These kind of pictures we have got from Bhimbetka and another Nagarjunakonda caves. Okay, now how they got the idea of circle, how they got the idea of triangle? So archaeologists came on a conclusion that circle from sun, triangle or square from land, okay, lines from trees, they must have acquired the idea. ठीक है, ऐसा था. मतलब ये ना थोड़ा सा टेक्निकलिटी हो गया, जस्ट फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग और फॉर योर नॉलेज. देर इज नथिंग टू डू विद योर पेपर. ये बस आप लोगों को समझाने के लिए. ओके, ठीक है. सो दैट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस. एंड व्हाई दे यूज्ड टू ड्रॉ सम पिक्चर्स, बिकॉज अ पार्ट ऑफ अम्यूजमेंट, लाइक लॉट्स ऑफ रेनफॉल दैट यूज टू हैपन. सो वट दे यूज टू लिफ्ट विद, they had nothing to do, they cannot go out for hunting, no animal they could found during that period. So they used to rest in those cave shelters, and to just pass the time they used to draw those pictures. Okay, that period was called hunters and gatherers. Okay, so jo gathering wala bhi tha wo wahi tha. Okay, what is the meaning of gather? Wo get wala nahi, gath wala. ठीक है, गैदर, गैदरिंग, लाइक यू आर हंटिंग एंड यू आर जस्ट गेटिंग इट. ऑब्वियसली दे आर नथिंग टू डू, कोई उनको थोड़ी जॉब पे जाना था कि आज दिन में, आज चलो छुट्टी है तो आज कुछ और करते हैं. दे हैड ओनली दैट वर्क. ओके, उनका दिन का काम ही यही था, दे हैव टू हंट फॉर देमसेल्फ, टू फीड देमसेल्फ. ओके, सो जब भी ऐसा कुछ होता था कि कुछ भी काम नहीं है तो बस यही करो. सो इट इज जस्ट एन आइडिया व्हाट आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट हैव डिराइव्ड. एग्जैक्टली वी डजंट नो. हम हिस्ट्री को अज्यूम कर सकते हैं, है ना, हम उसका डायरेक्ट कंक्लूजन पे तो नहीं पहुंच सकते कि यही ही होता था. वट एवर वी डू नॉट हैव एनी थिंग इन द रिटन फॉर्म, वी कैन अज्यूम इट. ठीक है, सो दैट वॉज दीज वर द थिंग्स. Then these periods that belongs to Paleolithic. Paleolithic में भी 3 divisions है, upper, middle, lower. Okay, so we'll discuss about that in further classes. Mesolithic is there, Neolithic is there. ठीक है, so what was why Neolithic? What is the meaning of Neolithic? What is the meaning of Mesolithic? पता है कुछ? Paleolithic is what? लिथिक माने स्टोन. ठीक है, लिथिक माने स्टोन, पेलियो माने ओल्ड, तो ओल्ड स्टोन एज. देन मिजो, मिजो माने मिडिल, मिडिल स्टोन. दिस इज अ ट्रांजिशन पीरियड. ठीक है, मिजोलिथिक इज ट्रांजिशन ऑफ पेलियोलिथिक एंड नियोलिथिक. व्हाई इट इज ट्रांजिशन? इन एनी ट्रांजिशनरी पीरियड यू कैन सी द एसेंस ऑफ अर्लियर सिविलाइजेशन, अर्लियर एरा एंड लेटर एरा. It is assimilation. You can see all the nature of both the eras. Okay, that is a transition period. Na, transition का मतलब ये था कि दोनों का essence होगा उसमें. So that was that essence we can see in the Mesolithic. ठीक है, Mesolithic में we do not have any, we do not found any evidence of agriculture. But in Neolithic we can get it. And what is a transition? Transition in the types of tools, stone implements. Okay, that is why it is called a transitionary period. ठीक है, in the Neolithic, that is neo is what? New. Yeah. So new stone age. In the new stone age, they, although they are having stone implements, and that they use in the agriculture, they now they do not using it for the hunting and gathering. They are using it for agriculture, for their consumption. हाँ, उसके वो यूज करते ही होंगे. अभी भी वो लिथिक एज है, स्टोन एज है, तो उसके वो इम्प्लीमेंट्स, अगर वो हैंड एक्स यूज करे तो एक्स का क्या, या तो पेड़ काटने के लिए, नहीं तो किसी को काटने के लिए. तो किसी भी चीज के लिए यूज कर सकते हैं. ओके, बट नियोलिथिक का यहाँ पे और देखो जो भी अजम्पशन है वो ना एविडेंस के ऊपर है. कैसे एविडेंस, क्यों नियो? क्योंकि इसमें एग्रीकल्चर का आपको एविडेंस मिलता है. कहाँ से? बलूचिस्तान, है ना, बलूचिस्तान में, पाकिस्तान, बलूचिस्तान में महेंद्रगढ़, है ना, वहाँ पे आपको क्या क्या मिलता है? मड हाउस मिलते हैं, वीट कल्टीवेशन का एविडेंस मिलता है, लेंटिल्स जो पल्सेस होते हैं उसके एविडेंसेस आपको मिलते हैं. तो मतलब एक हाँ तो मतलब आपको एक ऐसा एविडेंस मिल रहा है. अगर मड हाउस मिल रहा है मतलब वहाँ पे सोसाइटी आ चुकी थी. हाउस है मतलब सोसाइटी है, है ना. वी आर लिविंग इन अ सोसाइटी, वी आर पार्ट ऑफ अ सोसाइटी. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ वी आर सिविलाइज्ड. व्हाई वी आर सिविलाइज्ड? बिकॉज़ वी आर एजुकेटेड. वी आर लिविंग इन अ हाउसेस, है ना. हम प्री हिस्टोरिक की तरह भी जंगलों में या केव्स में तो नहीं रह रहे, है ना. वी फाउंड एन एविडेंस ऑफ हाउस. हाउस मीनिंग देयर इज अ सोसाइटी. ओके, इफ हाउसेस में पीपल आर लिविंग, देयर मस्ट बी समथिंग फॉर देयर सब्सिस्टेंस. एंड व्हाट वाज फॉर देयर सब्सिस्टेंस? दैट वाज एग्रीकल्चर, दैट वाज प्रोडक्शन ऑफ क्रॉप्स. ठीक है, एंड फ्रॉम डिफरेंट प्लेसेस वी हैव फाउंड दिस. और उसका हाउ हिस्टोरियंस और आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट दे गेट टू नो दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग बिलोंग्स टू दैट पीरियड, सो दैट इज थ्रू रेडियो कार्बन डेटिंग. ठीक है, सो दैट इज टू नो अबाउट द पीरियड, वट एवर एविडेंस बिलोंग्स टू वॉट पीरियड. ओके, सो if they found evidence of house, if they found evidence of grains, so through the carbon dating process. Okay, in the carbon dating process they get to know about the year, which particular year it belongs to. Then uske baad neolithic ke baad aata hai chalcolithic. theek hai, chalcolithic mein kya hota hai? Chalco mane copper, theek hai, lithic mane stone. So it is combination of copper plus stone. Copper mane metal, we have a resource. ठीक है, नेचुरल रिसोर्स. सो चालकोलिथिक इज, अच्छा अब चालकोलिथिक है. हियर वी डू नॉट हैव एनी ट्रेडिंग रूट और ट्रेडिंग रिलेशन विद एनी अदर कंट्री, सो वी कैन अज्यूम दैट दिस कॉपर बिलोंग्स टू इंडिया, दिस नेचुरल रिसोर्स बिलोंग्स टू इंडिया. हो सकता है ना, बाहर से तो हम नहीं लेके आ सकते हैं. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर रिसोर्स बिलोंग्स टू इंडिया. ठीक है, देन Indus Valley civilization is part of the Chalcolithic. Why it is part of Chalcolithic? Because Indus Valley civilization is having implements made of copper. Copper ka hai na? Copper ka kaise? Copper ka wo hai, mixture hai. That is bronze. Copper aur tin ka mixture. That is bronze. So it we can derive that it is one of the parts of this Chalcolithic period. ठीक है, आप अगर पढ़ोगे एनसीईआरटी में जो चालकोलिथिक पीरियड का चैप्टर है तो उसमें बहुत सारे वो है सिविलाइजेशन, जैसे सॉरी सिविलाइजेशन नहीं मतलब एराज है, लाइक जो कल्चर्स, जोरवे कल्चर और भी है कुछ डिफरेंट नेम्स है. ठीक है, एंड दीज जोरवे कल्चर अदर कल्चर्स दैट बिलोंग्स टू चालकोलिथिक, एंड उसी के अंदर ना इंडस वैली का भी स्टार्ट होता है हैबिटेशन. ठीक है, सेटलमेंट, बिकॉज Indus Valley civilization is purely based on bronze, and bronze is mixture of tin and copper. ठीक है, copper implements. So these are there. Then we'll go through Indus Valley civilization. We have discussed few things about IVC. ठीक है, we'll discuss another major things. And this IVC is part of your age, cultural or political? Cultural. क्योंकि उसमें पॉलिटिकल का आपको कुछ पता नहीं चलता है कि क्या क्या पॉलिटिकल में है. ठीक है, बिकॉज वी डू नॉट हैव एनी पॉलिटी काइंड ऑफ थिंग ड्यूरिंग एंशियंट वैली, वी हैव नॉट फाउंड एनी एविडेंस. ठीक है, वी हैव एविडेंसेस ऑफ देयर कल्चरल पार्ट, वेदर इट इज आर्किटेक्चर, वेदर इट इज ट्रेडिशंस. कल्चर में सब आता है ना, आर्किटेक्चर भी आता है, आपके फेस्टिवल्स आते हैं, आपका ट्रेडिशंस आता है, आपके कस्टम्स आते हैं, एवरीथिंग बिलोंग्स टू द कल्चरल पार्ट, है ना. सो विल टॉक अबाउट दैट, विल डिस्कस अबाउट दैट. देन उसके बाद विल मूव ऑन टू आर्यंस, उसका भी थोड़ा थोड़ा हमने डिस्कस किया. ठीक है, सो उसका फुल फ्लेश्ड चैप्टर्स विल डिस्कस अबाउट, देन लेटर वैदिक. ठीक है, लेटर वैदिक में देयर इज अ कंप्लीट चेंज इन द सोसाइटी फ्रॉम ऋग्वैदिक सोसाइटी टू लेटर वैदिक सोसाइटी. Why? Because here they have fully settled in the country till this later Vedic period. And when they fully settled in the country, then they started setting up their own rules. Earlier, they used to live on their rules, which they used to carry from the place where they belongs to. Okay, जो भी उनके ट्राइबल रूल्स हुआ करते थे वो उसको कैरी कर रहे थे. बट वेन दे स्टार्टेड सेटलिंग इन द कंट्री इन द इंडिया देन दे स्टार्टेड सेटिंग अप न्यू रूल्स लाइक वेरी यू कैन सी पॉपुलर थिंग इज देयर द वर्णा सिस्टम इमर्जेंस ऑफ द वर्णा सिस्टम वट वॉज देयर इन द ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड देर वॉज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ टेरिटरी लाइक ट्राइबल्स है ना ट्राइबल किंग वॉज देयर ट्राइबल किंग था ट्राइबल किंग का कोई पर्टिकुलर टेरिटरी नहीं होता था जहाँ वे भी सेटल हो गए वहाँ हो गए वहाँ का जो पर्टिकुलर जो मार्क है डिमार्केटेड एरिया वो उनका टेरिटरी हुआ करता था बट इन द लेटर वैदिक पीरियड ड्यूरिंग दिस बिफोर प्रायर टू दिस अर्बन सिविलाइजेशन दैट कॉन्सेप्ट स्टार्टेड बिल्डिंग अप एंड इन द सेकेंड अर्बनाइजेशन पीरियड 6th century BC पीरियड वी हैड टिल दैट टाइम वी हैड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्राइब सॉरी किंगडम्स ठीक है उससे पहले क्या था कि वो सेटल डाउन हो रहे थे अब सेटल डाउन हो गए किंगडम भी बन गया पर वो किंगडम चलेगा कैसे अनलेस वी आर हैविंग न्यू रूल्स विच वी कैन इम्पोज है ना कोई भी जो रूलर वी कैन सी इन द एंटायर करिकुलम एनी रूलर वेदर इट इज बिलोंग्स टू मेडिवल पीरियड इट बिलोंग्स टू एंशियंट और मॉडर्न पीरियड एनी रूलर they are having different rules hai na jaise koi bhi aap dekh lo utha karke gupta harsha they are having different rules hai na in the medieval period turks afghans then delhi sultanate kingdoms theek hai balban although he belongs to delhi sultanate but he belongs to the slave dynasty but he had different rules He didn't carry the rules which used to happen earlier. He set up his own rules, and that is there in the time of Aryans also. In the later Vedic period, when this kingdom concept of kingdom emerged, concept of king emerged. So king that Varna system also emerged. Why this Varna system? Because with this Varna system, the society where they used to live, that got divided. That the concept of society also emerged a new concept of society emerged and that concept of society was based on the varna system kya tha us varna system what was the problem in that varna system differentiation to tha par kya tha problem kya thi usme hereditary actually हेरिडिटरी कैसे लेकिन देखो जो वर्णा सिस्टम था ना ऐसा नहीं था कि वर्णा सिस्टम वॉज नॉट प्रेजेंट ड्यूरिंग ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड इट वॉज प्रेजेंट वी कैन सी इन अ टेक्स्ट ऑफ ऋग्वेदा पुरुष सूक्ता वॉज अ चैप्टर इन द टेक्स्ट ऑफ ऋग्वेदा इन विच दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वर्णा सिस्टम हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड ठीक है दैट वॉज देयर इन द ड्यूरिंग द ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड But during later Vedic period, what they did, they just converted this Varna system into birth. Now, this Varna system was decided on the basis of occupation. Like, अभी क्या है? जैसे if I talk about this Varna, ठीक है? Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. If any person was a religious teacher if any person was a priest during Rigvedic period to wo brahmin hota tha if any person if my father is a priest theek hai to wo brahmin ho gaya agar main yahan pe padha rahi hu to main bhi brahmin hi hungi kyunki wo bhi isi ka part aata hai theek hai if I owned any territory but my father he was involved in the teaching or in the priestly kind of thing so he was brahmin but in the same family one kshatriya was also there why that was based on the occupation theek hai so during rig vedic period multiple varnas were there in a family theek hai ek phrase bhi aata hai wo hum padha bhi hoga aur wo hum usko discuss bhi karenge isme chapters mein so multiple varnas existed in इन वन फैमिली. हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल. लेटर वैदिक, नॉट वैदिक, लेटर वैदिक. वट एवर प्रॉब्लम वी आर सीइंग इन दिस सोसाइटी टुडे, दैट इज यू नो उसका जो जेनेसिस है, दैट इज इट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम हियर. वर्ण सिस्टम हियर, वट हैपन्ड, दिस वर्ण सिस्टम विच अर्लियर यूज टू डिसाइडेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑक्यूपेशन, नाउ इट इज डिसाइडेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बर्थ. अ पर्सन, a priest's son would be a priest or a brahmin, theek hai. A king's son would be a king, that belongs to kshatriya. A shudra's son belongs to shudra because he has taken born in a shudra family. Wahi hota hai aaj bhi, hai na. Later on when society developed, then this shudra's among these shudras, acha shudra which jo tha, that was not untouchable during this later period, Vedic period, in this Varna system, that was not untouchable. This untouchability concept, it came later on, but genesis we can see during this period. Okay, why, what is the genesis of this? We can see that this shudra, that they meant to serve to all the upper three varnas, okay, brahmin, vaishya, kshatriya and vaishyas. ठीक है, तो ये इनको सर्व करने के लिए बने थे. एंड दीज शूद्रास, दे यूज टू व्हाट दे हैड ऑक्यूपेशंस, देवर स्लेव्स, देवर एग्रीकल्चरल लेबरर्स. तो यह अनटचेबिलिटी का कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं था, देवर हाउस होल्ड स्लेव्स, देवर हाउस होल्ड सर्वेंट्स. ठीक है, ऐसा था. तो अनटचेबिलिटी का कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं था, बट ये था कि दे हैव टू सर्व देमसेल्व्स फॉर अपर थ्री वर्णास. Okay, this untouchability came, we can see one evidence at the time of Ashoka's, theek hai, but wahan pe bhi untouchability nahi hai. Concept of malechas during Gupta's period, malech, chandal, theek hai. To Gupta period mein na bahut sari achhi cheeze bhi hui thi, buri cheeze bhi hui thi. We will discuss all such things. And as we discussed that India is land of invaders. Why it is land of invaders? Like after Aryan invasion, when Aryan settled down, so Aryan was a biggest tribe. और उसके बाद फिर यही होता है ना कि आपका population बढ़ता जाता है, then your genes get multiplied, है ना. आज भी we say that we are Aryans, है ना. हमारे genes multiply होते 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 इतना हमने सदियां बिता दी. हमारे जो जो हमारे अंदर blood है वो भी Aryan race का ही है, है ना. ऐसा ही चल रहा है. बट वट यूज टू हैपन इन द इंडिया ड्यूरिंग एंशियंट टाइम ऑल्सो, लाइक डिफरेंट इन्वेडर्स, दे यूज टू कम टू इंडिया थ्रू वेस्टर्न पार्ट, थ्रू वेस्टर्न पासिस, है ना. कुछ ग्रीक्स आए, कुछ सिंथियंस आए, तो उनका ना एसिमिलेशन हुआ विद द रेसेस लिविंग इन द इंडिया, लाइक आर्यन रेस लिविंग इन द इंडिया. तो जो आर्यंस थे वो और जो लोग बाहर से आए, तो ऑब्वियसली दे हैड मैरिज अलायंसेस, दे हैड वॉर्स, दे हैड ऑक्यूपाइड. तो ऑब्वियसली दैट दैट सोसाइटी गेट एसिमिलेटेड इनटू लिविंग सोसाइटी, और लिविंग सोसाइटी गॉट एसिमिलेटेड इनटू द सोसाइटी विच केम फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. अच्छा, एक चीज और दिमाग में आई थी, मैं भूल ही गई, पता नहीं वाई आई स्किप सो मेनी थिंग्स. ठीक है, सो प्रॉब्लम स्टार्टेड, वट एवर प्रॉब्लम वी कैन सी इन दिस सोसाइटी, इट स्टार्टेड विद दिस वर्ण सिस्टम. ओके, एंड वी कैन सी इफ रिलीजियस मूवमेंट टेक प्लेस ड्यूरिंग एंशियंट पीरियड, दैट वॉज ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन दिस वर्ण सिस्टम. उसका जो बेसिस था वो था वर्ण सिस्टम पे ही. वाई? बिकॉज इफ यू सी जैनिज्म और बुद्धिज्म, दे टारगेटेड वर्ण सिस्टम. उनके आप उसमें टेक्स्ट में पढ़ोगे भी. When we will discuss this chapter, so we will discuss why this religious movement took place. What was the reason behind it? ठीक है, और what were their teachings behind it? So we'll discuss all such things. Then after that, Shraman tradition. Shraman is what? सुना है कभी Shraman? Shraman. सुना है कभी? श्रमण ट्रेडिशन इज नॉन वैदिक. नॉन वैदिक श्रमण ट्रेडिशन, श्रमण ट्रेडिशन इज अ रिलीजियस मूवमेंट, दैट इज नॉन वैदिक रिलीजियस मूवमेंट. ठीक है, विल डिस्कस इट. अच्छा हाँ, क्या आया था मेरे दिमाग में, फिर से भूल गई. ठीक है, ओके. हाँ अच्छा, शूद्रास का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है, do you know what is the concept behind Shudra? What is the concept behind the partition of this Shudra Varna? Who were Shudras during that time? सब तो आर्यंस ही थे, सब तो आर्यंस ही थे ना, तो आर्यन में ही क्यों शूद्रास हुए, आर्यन में ही क्यों वैश्यास हुए? हाँ एग्जैक्टली, जो लोग जो ऋग्वेदिक टाइम पे जो लोग इसमें इस ऑक्यूपेशन में थे वो फिर लेटर वैदिक में दे कन्वर्टेड, बट शूद्रा का कॉन्सेप्ट थोड़ा सा डिफरेंट है. शूद्रा का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या है, व्हेन आर्यंस केम इनटू इंडिया, सो जो इंडिजीनियस सेटलमेंट था दैट वॉज इंडस वैली, दैट वॉज इंडस वैली ना. सो इंडस वैली में ऐसा तो नहीं हो सकता कि सबको मार करके दे स्टार्टेड देयर न्यू सिविलाइजेशन, न्यू सेटलमेंट, ऐसा तो नहीं था. कुछ लोग तो रहे होंगे ना इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन के, तो जो रियल हैबिटेट थे, इनहैबिटेड थे, ठीक है, जो इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन के जो लोग थे उनको दे स्टार्टेड कंसिडरिंग एज शूद्रा. ओके, और देयर इज अ मेंशन ऑफ द टर्म दास और दासियूज इन द ऋग्वेदिक टेक्स्ट, दास और दासियूज. तो ये दास और दासियों कोई नहीं था, देवर इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन पीपल होम दे कन्फ्रंटेड. तो जो लोग बच गए थे उस क्लैश में, ऑब्वियसली ऐसा तो नहीं होता है, डोमिनेट ही करती है ना. अगर इन्वेजन ऑफ स्पीशीज भी होता है तो स्पीशीज क्या करती है, डोमिनेट करती है ना, सारी स्पीशीज को तो खत्म नहीं कर देती है. जो लोग थोड़े से पावरफुल रहते हैं वो बच जाते हैं, जो थोड़े से वीक होते हैं वो मर जाते हैं. तो वही चीज आईवीसी में भी हुआ, हु सस्टेन्ड इट दे स्टिल रिमेन्ड, और जो लोग रह गए दे स्टार्टेड ट्रीटिंग देम दास और दासियूज. एंड दिस दास एंड दासियू ड्यूरिंग लेटर वैदिक पीरियड दैट converted into Shudras, and Shudras converted into lower caste people, Dalits, untouchables. So untouchability का concept India में ही emerge हुआ है, पर किसके लिए हुआ है, जो India के own habitat थे, inhabited थे. तो कुछ भी ऐसा है नहीं real life में कि कुछ untouchability kind of चीज होती है. So this is all in our mind, this is all in our mindset. Okay. So, ये जो भी प्रॉब्लम थी, जो कास्ट रिलेटेड प्रॉब्लम्स है, वो सारी हमारी वर्ण सिस्टम से शुरू होती है. एंड ड्यूरिंग दैट पीरियड ऑल्सो, ड्यूरिंग एंशियंट पीरियड ऑल्सो, सम पीपल दे स्टार्टेड टारगेटिंग वर्ण सिस्टम, सम हाउ दे सक्सीडेड, बट हिंदू रिलीजन दैट वॉज सो डोमिनेटेड एंड दैट रिवाइव्ड लेटर ऑन एंड दे हेल्ड देयर डोमिनेंस अगेन. और जो वो श्रवण ट्रेडिशन था उसका जो सिग्निफिकेंस था वो इट जस्ट लॉस्ट. ठीक है, देन इन दिस सोसाइटी, इन द एंशियंट सोसाइटी अलोंग विद आर्यंस, वी कैन सी इन द एंशियंट पीरियड वी कैन डिफरेंट इन्वेजन्स लाइक ईरानियंस. ईरानियन कौन, अलेक्जेंडर. अलेक्जेंडर आया था इंडिया में, ठीक है. अलेक्जेंडर के बाद ग्रीक्स, Parthians, Scythians, they started moving towards India. But what was the reason behind that their movement? Reason kya ho sakta unke movement ke? So we'll discuss it. Jo uska major reason tha, reason was that they were also nomadics. These Greeks, Scythians, Parthians, they were also nomadic. They used to, they wanted to expand their territory. So for that aspiration, they used to move towards China, ठीक है, China के territory को they used to expand or they used to get it. But what China did during ancient period, China created that Great Wall of China, what is existing today also. So that Great Wall of China that they built during ancient period, you can see like 5th or 6th century, ठीक है, that period they built that Great Wall of China, and because of that Great Wall, that blocked the road of those invaders to move towards China, ठीक है, and because of that they started moving towards India. ये था reason, okay. Then थोड़ी सी बस चीजें हम लोग discuss कर लेते हैं, उसके बाद हम next session से अपना स्टार्ट करेंगे. देन एज आई सेड आफ्टर दोज किंगडम्स, सो आफ्टर सेटलिंग डाउन एंड आफ्टर क्रिएटिंग द किंगडम्स फ्रॉम दीज आर्यंस, वी कैन सी द एराज ऑफ किंग्स लाइक मौर्यास, नंदास, ठीक है, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट किंग्स आए. इट स्टार्टेड विद हरियंक डायनेस्टी, ठीक है, हरियंक आए, उसके बाद नंदाज, उसके बाद मौर्याज, देन शिशुनाग, लॉट्स ऑफ किंग्स एंड किंगडम्स. एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वट वॉज द इम्पॉर्टेंस एंड वट आर द सिग्निफिकेंस इन योर एग्जामिनेशन. सो वील कवर एवरीथिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वेश्चंस और अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिलेबस you are having in the history, okay, related to the kings. Because in the ancient history, we have to focus on the political, we have to focus on the cultural. So, cultural mein kya karna hai, political mein kya karna hai, wo bhi political tab aata hai, jab humara Mahajanpat concept aa jata hai, during 6th century BC. Theek hai, so we'll do it from there. Then, after decline of Mauryas, we can see another kingdoms which emerged in India and some came from outside. So we will discuss about those things also. Then Guptas, then Vardhans. So Vardhan पे जो हमारा ancient history होता है, it just ended. ठीक है, उसके बाद हमारा medieval history होता है. Why medieval history? Why it is called medieval history? ठीक है, medieval भी वही transition है ancient और modern का. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे भी culmination है. Medieval history में we just enter into a different religion. ठीक है, पूरा एक transition ही हो जाता है. अब क्या हो रहा है, पहले क्या होता था कि जैसे हिंदू रिलीजन आया और जो लोग लाइक इंडिया में जो रिलीजन था, जैसे हिंदुइज्म था, जैनिज्म आया बाद में, बुद्धिज्म आया, सो हूसोएवर इन्वेडर्स दे यूज्ड टू कम टू इंडिया, दे एज आई सेड द इंडियाज इंडिया वाज हैविंग अ वेरी ग्लोरिफाइड पास्ट ड्यूरिंग एंशियंट पीरियड. सो दे यूज्ड टू लाइक द एसेंस ऑफ द रिलीजन्स विच वर प्रिवेलिंग इन इंडिया. हिंदुइज्म का कुछ अच्छा लग जाता था, बुद्धिज्म का कुछ अच्छा लग जाता था. तो जो भी किंग्स दे यूज टू कम इन इंडिया, दे यूज टू अडैप्ट द रिलीजन. यू कैन सी लाइक कनिष्का, ही प्रोपेगेटेड व्हाट, बुद्धिज्म. कनिष्का ने बुद्धिज्म को प्रोपेगेट किया ना. सो एंड ही ऑल्सो लाइक्ड हिंदुइज्म. वी कैन सी द एसिमिलेशन ऑफ हिंदुइज्म इन टू बुद्धिज्म, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट. ठीक है, गुप्तास का क्या था, गुप्तास दे प्रोपेगेटेड Hinduism, but they also propagated Buddhism. But the dominance of religion was Hinduism. We can see through temple architecture. Temple architecture is the part of Hinduism. ठीक है, why? Because Hindu gods का था, Shiva, Parvati, Hindu gods. ठीक है, Buddhism, Jainism का कहाँ हमको मिलता है, during Kanishka, Kushans. ठीक है, so we'll discuss about these things. In the ancient part, then in medieval part, lots of kingdoms like Muslim invaders, they came to India. Some they just came for a purpose to loot the wealth. Why? Because they through the foreign accounts they got to know about glorious past of history history of India, and they had a picture that India is really a what's a golden bird, sone ki chidiya. है ना, सो दे हैड एन इम्प्रेशन फॉर इंडिया दैट इंडिया इज रियली अ गोल्डन बर्ड. एंड वाई इट इज अ गोल्डन बर्ड, बिकॉज डिफरेंट किंग्स दे हैव कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू रिलीजन एंड दे हैव क्रिएटेड सम, यू नो, वी हैव एज वी फाउंड सम एविडेंसेज लाइक दे हैव क्रिएटेड सम, यू कैन सी स्कल्पचर्स, एंड दो स्कल्पचर्स दैट वॉज मेड अप ऑफ वेरी फाइन टेक्सचर ऑफ, यू कैन सी सैंडस्टोन और एनी अदर natural resources they have used, and it was very, you know, you can say expensive. Or temples we had, in the temple we had wealth, hai na, temple mein kya hota hai, zyada paisa hota hai, sona hota hai, we have golds, we have another ornaments, we have money. So they used to come to Muslim invaders, they used to come to India and they used to loot the wealth. Okay, but later on they some of them they started settling down in India. Why? Because they liked the society, they got assimilated into the society. There were some good things, there were some bad things. So different kingdoms were there, we can see, we will discuss about that. Then in the medieval India, what we have to focus, we do not have to focus everything, we have to focus on the political kind of. So in the political history, what we have to see some different you can see the terms given in the NCRT related to different kingdoms. ठीक है, so we'll focus on that. Why? Because UPSC asks question based on in this, and that is in the prelims, not in the mains. From in the mains, from medieval India, they ask question based on cultural things, and they may ask because these days they are asking about ancient culture, not medieval culture. ठीक है, but anyhow we have to prepare for it. So medieval period में you can see Mughal architecture. you can see Delhi Sultanate architecture. So we will cover the cultural part majorly in the medieval period also, and our focus would be on modern. Why? Because modern, it is having a good edge in prelims and as well as mains. So we'll focus on that, and different themes are there. So we'll discuss about that. So next class mein jab bhi milte hain, we'll move further on the chapters. Theek hai? Chalo. Thank you. Okay, one more thing, yes, author of NCERT, I discussed in the class, Akshay. Like for ancient history, you have to refer, in the old NCERT, you have to refer R.S. Sharma. Ancient ke liye hai R.S. Sharma, Ram Charan Sharma. Okay, and for medieval, you have to refer Satish Chandra. For medieval, you have to refer Satish Chandra. For modern history, you have to refer Bipin Chandra. Theek hai? So these are the authors what we have to refer, and in the lower classes, you to the theme series, that is okay. Theek hai? Refer these books, okay? Because they have good concepts, and in the theme series they have many facts, okay? So those facts, as I said, that is helpful in another examination, not for CSE, okay? So we'll discuss about that. So thank you so much. I hope this session was helpful for you, and we'll discuss about the chapters in the further sessions. Thank you so much. We would meet with the other sessions. Thanks.